Hello everybody and welcome to this very fast review of the Profoto Air Remote DTL F. Maybe as you might have seen or know, I'm Dutch and normally I make my videos also in Dutch, but because I got a lot of questions about the Air Remote DTL F, I'm gonna do this one in English. So I hope you won't mind my Dutch accent, but I will try to speak as clearly and good English enough as I can. But if it sounds Dutch, I'm sorry, but I'm trying and hope you can forgive me. First, I want to start with the ease of use. The Air Remote DTL F is really easy to use. Only thing you have to do when you start, put it on your camera, push the on button, and it will start. At this moment, when you put it in TTL modes, it will be really easy to work with. You just have to point and shoot, and your lights will be adjusted accordingly. One thing to remember, if you want to adjust your light in TTL mode, if you use one light, use the flash compensation from your camera. This will always be the leading flash compensation. When you use multiple lights, use the group compensation here in the display from the remote. The first thing you have to do when you get the Profoto Air Remote DTL for Fujifilm, because that's what the F is standing for. The first thing you have to do is put the latest firmware update on your camera. Check the update of if there is an update for the remote and update your lights. Because if you don't have the latest firmware update, the TTL and HSS function will work, but it will have some bugs. But everything will be fixed as soon as you put the latest firmware update on your camera and your light. And the reason I point that way, because I use a D2 at this moment to put some light on me, because it's really dark in the studio. It's winter, it's in the Netherlands, so it's dark. After you updated the camera and the remote, you got bi-directional communication. So when I push the manual mode, also in my camera, it will switch from TTL to manual and back. I can change the sync, first curtain, second curtain and HSS. And I can switch the channel here below and the groups here. I can choose to switch on and off the modeling light from the remote. I can switch the power on and off from the light. I can use a test. And now I don't see because it is in full power. Another function which is really great with this unit is the HSS function. Why is HSS really nice to have? Well, mainly when you work outside. When you want to balance natural light with flashlight, you are always limited by the sync speed. And normally when you're around 125th or 250th of a second sync speed, you have to use your aperture to dial down the amount of natural light. Well, with HSS, you can use your shutter speed to dial down the amount of natural light. So you can use wide open apertures, even on a bright sunny day, and use flash to balance everything out. It's really handy, especially when you work with like the GFX camera, which has normally have a max sync speed of 125th of a second. Some people will say, yeah, but when you use HSS, you got a lot of power loss. And yes, I calculate it between 5 and 7 stops of loss on the maximum mode around an 8,000th of a second. But the moment you use this, mainly you do it because you want to use a wide aperture, like 1.2, 1.8, f2. When you use this wide apertures, you only need a small amount of flashlight to fill your picture. So you don't even need the highest powers. Another thing to keep in mind, HSS and the flash only work when you use the mechanical shutter, not when you use the electronic shutter. I've tested the Profoto Arri mod with multiple cameras, and at this moment it will support the X-T2, X-Pro2, X100F and the GFX50S camera from Fujifilm. Later I hope also the other cameras will have firmware updates so you can use the Profoto Arri mod TTL F-trigger with all the other cameras. From a Profoto side, I've tested it using an A1 Canon version. As soon as you use it as an off-camera light, you can fully TTL trigger it with the TTL F-trigger. Also, I tested with the B1, the B1X, the D2 and the B2 lights, and I heard also you can work with the Pro 10. So almost the complete Profoto range, you can use TTL and HSS with this trigger. The first con I want to address is the battery life. On my original Arri mod without the TTL, I'm still working with the first pair of batteries I got with it. This one, after about 6 weeks of normal use, I'm on my third pack of AAA batteries. But that's easily explainable goal because the Arri mod has to do a lot less calculating than this one with the TTL and HSS function. Another little bit of a con: with this remote I can command A, B and C group, but with the Arri remote I also can use D, E, F and G, I believe. But it doesn't have to be a problem because normally I don't even use more than three lights. Normally I only use one light and maybe two. This was the short review about the Profoto Arri Remote TTL F. If you would like it, I can make a full tutorial and review later this year, maybe begin of January. So if you would like that, please drop a line below and I will make it for you. If you got any feedback, questions, please let me know. This was this video for now. If you want to see more of my videos and work, please follow me on one of the channels below. I'm on Instagram, I'm on YouTube, as you can see me now, and on Facebook. Most of my videos will be in Dutch, but if there are requests, I will make them in English too. And I want to finish as always with: we are not crazy, we are creatives, and see you the next time. Bye bye.